I'm feeling brave.
Something gave way.
Good old construction adhesive.
The shelf will be good as new. Hang on, I gotta get one of my long reach clamps.
Oh, yeah.
It's a homemade clamporama.
You know what? I should get one of my long reach clamps to help you with that.
How much weight can yours exert? How much?
At least 200 pounds.
Really? This has to put in at least 202.
Well, we should build a jig where we have the two clamps against each other to see which one will break first. If you're willing to sacrifice one of your clamps, we could do that.
Would you be willing to sacrifice one of yours?
I have no intention of sacrificing one of mine. I know it. I know it'll win.
Well, when you put it that way, as long as we're breaking things today.
Yeah.
The problem with these ones is that you keep turning and turning and turning. Because these parts flex, this doesn't. Yeah.
Like mine doesn't flex quite as much. Because I don't rely on like this wimpy threaded rod for the strength. I rely on wood.
But this is wood.
Yeah, but you got the steel is the weak part on yours, I think.
No, I don't think so. See, if that was just joined there with box joints, that would have blown apart already.
Okay, we're gonna have to put this to the test.
I don't know how much pressure that is, but.
You have a bathroom scale?
No.
If you're willing to drill a hole in the middle of that, we'll just put a dowel indicator on it. Okay, I think we got this all right. The controls aren't where they're supposed to be.
Huh?
On your bandsaw, it's like, where's the fucking knob? It's supposed to be here!
This is a real bad sound, not a...
The switch is in the wrong place.
What's going on? What are you doing? I'm lost. This is my idea. You're excluding me. Include me.
To just put a little mark, like 12 inches from either side of that, so we can consistently place the blocks.
Oh, the pivot points.
Yeah, exactly.
I don't know if that's really that important, is it? Well, if we're the same, though, if we're the same for both.
Well, the thing is, what might happen is we knock the pieces from going from one to the next.
And then
we won't remember where it is.
Our memory's up. Apparatus.
Gotta be scientific. So now, if we just set this to zero...
I'm not making any special claims for my current clamp. I know that it does what I want it to do.
So John Heisz was just using one of his long reach C clamps, and I was making fun of it that mine are stronger. And John Heisz had this cool idea for rigging up this apparatus for testing his strength with it. So we're just going to squeeze these together, and the dial indicator is going to show how much force, roughly, or some measure of force, so we can compare which of these clamps can squeeze harder. Okay, first up, my long reach C-clamp. The clamp goes in exactly in the middle of this board. And we have these two things exactly 1 foot on either side.
Okay, that's one revolution. Two. Coming up on, almost up on, nearly there, three and a quarter.
Okay, I think that's
the start and fade a little bit.
That's as far as I'm going to go.
Three and a half.
Unless John's goes further.
Three and a half. That's pretty impressive. That hard maple, 1x4, deflected down, I would have to say 3/8 of an inch. For sure, in the middle.
Of course, the clamp itself deflected more than that because there's less wood on the clamp than what we're squeezing here.
Well, that's the thing that with the homemade clamps. They're not made out of steel. Here we go. Now I've got a riser block because mine is more open. So I'm going to put that in place first. This is going to take a lot of cranking. Mine flexes more readily.
Mm-hmm.
Have you got a revolution yet?
One. You're at one.
Haven't reached two yet?
Almost at two.
Really?
Two now? That's impressive. I might have to put mine on there again. I mean, if you can do 3.5, I'll have to crank mine up to 4.
How's it looking?
2.25.
Can't be moving very fast.
No.
The clamp is flexing.
Yeah, it's at 2.5, getting to 2.5 now.
I'm going to keep going until either I reach 3.5 or this thing breaks. Because I'm all in on this one, man. How are we looking?
You're coming up on 2.75.
Okay, I'm getting resistance now, significant resistance.
It's probably just because it's kind of getting bent. Like that clamp is
down?
Becoming seriously opening up.
Yeah.
It's still at 2.75.
It hasn't moved?
Well, it's moving a little bit still. It's coming up on 3. I mean, the needle's getting close to 3 while you're cranking, but then it comes back.
See, what's happening here is this rod's going sideways again, see?
Uh-huh.
How is it?
It's within 1/10 hour of 3. Okay, it's at 3 now. You're at 3. I mean, it's going way past 3 right now while you're cranking, but again, like, steady state is going
back. Because, look, I bet you when it... How's that look when I push up like that?
Oh, yeah, that's going to...
Like, if I straighten that up.
3.25.
So, it's the flexing of the rod. You can see the rod starting to bend, too. Oh. So, this is really goddamn strong here, man. Oh, I'm hearing cracking.
Yeah, you're down to 3.
What?
You're down to 3 now. Yeah, it's this is when I was doing my joint testing. You get to a certain point where the force stops going up. Where the, you know, it's...
Has it changed?
Yeah, it's let go. You're at just over 3. And it's kind of drifting downwards.
Okay, let me push it.
Okay, let's get it. It's 3.4.
I could equal yours.
Okay, yeah? Maybe I'll just have to crank mine up to 4 now.
Will it make it?
I think so.
I can still crank this, although...
You're down to 3 again.
Yeah, it's starting to...
Yeah, it's just like the stretch on the thread, like the threaded rod, I think it's just stretching it a little too much.
And it's crushing in the back here, you can see.
Yeah.
Which is really something else.
So you need a box joint.
Now, the whole frame of the saw, of the...
Your threaded rod, look at that threaded rod, it's just way bent.
Well, yours is bigger, so... And the throat depth...
Oh, I'm covering your camera.
Okay, see the pad is breaking. Check it in the front there and see what we're at.
I think that's 3.5. Either that or it's down to 2.5. That's 3.75 now.
Okay. So the strength is there. The problem is this rod is too small.
Well, yeah, and this joint is just starting to yield right there in a big way.
Yeah, but it's giving, but it's not giving out. It's not breaking.
That's true. I think my joints, when they go, it's because the wood snaps, so it'll just go pop.
Yeah,
it'll be.
Like you wouldn't be able to take it this far. This is flexed way out. Like, I think this has opened up maybe 2.5 inches here.
Yeah.
So anyway. Kind of a apples and oranges type of test here.
Oh well, yeah, you're up against superior technology.
Hang on, let me see now if there's another clamp. How about one of my red ones there? How do you think they'll fare?
Probably better because you don't have as much leverage. Because like this here would have if this hadn't opened up such an angle, this up here wouldn't have been as much of a problem. Like if it hadn't opened up such an angle in the back, then the front would have been straight, and you wouldn't have had the problem there.
You can see this part gave way more than this one. But without the thread rod, that wouldn't have worked at all. So let's try this one. Yeah, this is my least strong wooden clamp other than that thing because of the notches in the front.
You know, I should stand on that afterwards to calibrate it because I know I weigh about 150-odd pounds with clothes on.
Yeah? See how much it deflects?
Yeah.
Where are we at?
One. Sorry, no, that's two.
Well, something's starting to crack.
You're coming up on three?
Yeah.
Whoa.
Yeah, see, that's where they break, right on those notches.
Yeah. Actually, let me just try one of my clamps again. I really didn't want to,
okay,
like...
Okay, at this point, it's just showing off, okay?
That's right.
You know that, right?
And the thing is, I didn't want to risk breaking my clamp, just because they're kind of a pain in the ass to make, which is why I didn't crank... You know, I felt pretty safe at how far I cranked it.
Okay, you're coming up on one now. Two... Three, three and three quarters, four.
Okay, that's enough.
Four, you start, you know, when it went past four, it started to fall back. Are you getting cracking?
I hear something's popping.
You better go. You might as well go, because at this point...
Yeah, I think that's how... You think so?
No, yeah, I can hear the cracking.
I think, that top joint, I think, is starting to go. Where are we at?
It's making it to 4.5.
Okay, let's back off then.
Oh, you chicken, man.
Yeah.
Oh, you chicken. I destroyed mine. Two of them, actually. I destroyed this one.
Well, I went to four. Actually, this is, I think this joint is starting to yield a little bit.
Just behind the scale.
Hang on, go slow. That's one, okay, and a half. That's one and three quarters, you could say. It goes up to two when you bounce a little bit. So
let's try again.
One and three quarters.
Okay.
So I don't know if that's a ratio, like you would directly multiply that by three, or the number that it went up to, right? Mine went up to 3.5. Yours went up to 4.5, almost.
Okay.
So would it be that much? Would it be...
Well, we should assume it's fairly linear, I guess, because, you know, we didn't crack the wood at all, like this part.
Okay, yeah.
A little over 2.5. You're a big guy.
I need to go on diet.
Shelf-breaking guy.
Anybody needs any shelves tested, I'm your man.
Yeah.
You can do the job test. Kinda.